Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to part two of the making of the Gladiator. Part one, I showed you roughly how I make a master out of wood. Now that's done, we're going to change that master into some resin cast. Even if you don't intend to sell any of your lures, I think it's a bit stupid not to have the option of making different models with your own design, unless you like carving a lot of timber. But I like to have the a consistent subject where I can walk on, especially with the density and the diving speed of it. So far now, I managed to have three full resin cast, and they came out really, really nice. They need a little bit more sanding, and I'm gonna prep them, and then it's gonna be the tricky part of weighing them, and then we're gonna paint them and clear coat them. So that'll be probably part three. Part four, we'll go fishing with it, so we'll see. It'll be exciting. But part two, yeah, I'm gonna show you now how to make a silicone mold, and after, with that mold, how to pour resin. All right, hope you enjoy. Thanks. Second part. So easiest way to create a mold is definitely with Legos. I keep it in here because it's not an exhibit or an evidence bag. It's just that inside it's air drying clay. That's the clay I use to do the imprints of the glide that's going to go inside like this, to make the first pour of silicone. And the handy thing with the Lego is that it's customizable. You can do a bigger frame, a smaller frame, a bigger, a thicker one, depends on the glide that you have. So if you have kids, you know where to get your Legos. If you don't, well, then you can get a big box on Amazon for about 50 euro. Most of the glides that I produce, I find that a thickness of four Legos is plenty. Just fill that with clay or plasticine. I like actually to put it in the bag because I can smooth it and have the nice surface even everywhere with the plastic. It makes it nice and easy, and you end up with a nice smooth surface to put your glide in. So now that's done, we're going to put the glide inside. We're going to sink it halfway, right bang in the middle like this. And then after, we're going to raise the Legos another four layers, and then we're going to be ready to pour in the silicone, mix it and pour it. Okay, I filled then the four layers of Lego with clay, and now I'm just like making nice and smooth the whole clay around, so it'll be easier to walk around. And then you end up with a mold that's a little bit cleaner. You get nice edges on your mold. It's worth in the long run, like, to spend a few minutes getting all that nice and neat. But like I said, that's why I keep it in plastic, because like that it doesn't dry too quick. So where you place your master, it's kind of important to consider that you want a nice edge around of silicone to be able to hold your mold nice and tight. And then you have to think as well where you're going to pour, because we're going to have to make a pour hole somewhere up here. So put that into consideration, like leave a good bit of room in and around. So like that you don't waste silicone, because it's quite expensive silicone nowadays. So I'm going to just press it down like this. And then I'm going to just roughly cut the shape around like this. That give me an idea of where the thing has to go, and I'm just going to scoop out roughly. Now the important thing is to create a really perfect seal, a nice neat seal all around the bait here, all around. I think I'm about in the middle now. You can always push it in a bit. Okay, and now I'm just gonna feel the edges. I'm gonna smooth all that like this. You can use a tool, you can use the back of your hand, you can use whatever you're comfortable with. If your clay is not too dry, if it's nice and moist, it's fairly easy to handle like this. I finished. I had everything nice and neat around all the glide there, nice and tight. Because you just have to remember that's where the resin's gonna go, your cast after. So the cleanest, the better. The tidiest, the better. So now what we need to do is to create a little pour hole that's going to come out of the bait. This is where we're going to pour the resin from the mold. So I usually get a little bit of clay. Do a kind of a little sausage, cocktail sausage. Place it onto the bait like this. I'm going to cut it just here. And that's going to be one side of the pour hole. Now, one thing that can happen when you do this pouring resin is that sometimes you might have a little bit of air that gets trapped. So first of all, you want to mix your resin really well. And what I like to add is a couple of little breather holes. So you can make this just with a little bit of a toothpick. I usually like to put a couple like that. So because the resin expands as it dries, it's going to push this bubble of air, as if you have any, created and out through these little tunnels, if you want. So I'm going to put one here and one up here. And then that should dissipate any air bubbles that may create in here. So that's it. That's what we have done. Now we're ready to play a bit of Lego and build another four layers over the top. And once we have that accomplished, we're going to be ready to pour some silicone, mix some silicone first and then pour the silicone.
Ouais.
Now, when you finish playing with Legos for another half an hour to build the two sections like that, we're ready to pour the silicone. So the silicone that I use is basically the one I found on Amazon for a DIY project. You get different sizes. I started with the small ones, but I needed two sets every time I wanted to do one cast. So I just went and bought the bigger set. I think this works at about 50, 60 euro, I think. Now, the way that silicone works, it takes quite a long time to dry properly. It shouldn't. It says you can demold after 24 hours. But I found here with the humidity and the cold and that we're having, it's not the best time to do this kind of project. So I just have to crank up the heating. I'm in t-shirt now and starting to sweat. The dog is wondering what's going on. It's summertime. So that silicone, it's a 50-50% mix. So I just do it by weight. Made your initial mix to leave it standing for about 10 minutes. It's long drying, so you don't have too much worry. Leave it 10 minutes sitting just for the bubble of air that you created by mixing it to get out. And even so, after the first pour you're going to do over the your wooden master, you want to do just a really, really thin layer just to engulf the whole bottom, if you want, of the cast and let it sit like that. So having that really thin layer, it's going to be much easier for all these micro bubbles to come up and pop out. Leave it for another 15-20 minutes like that for that skin just to have no bubbles at all, and that's going to give you a really nice cast. And then after, you can remix more and pour over the top just to fill up the fourth layer of Legos. All right, let's do this now. Okay, we're exactly 24 hours after pouring the first silicone. It's set nicely. I had lots of heating in the house for the last 24 hours. So now what we need to do is turn the mold, to the other side, which is going to reveal the clay that we poured, we put the first time. So all we need to do is remove the clay and prep the surface of the silicone and pour the second part of the silicone. Wait another 24 hours, I'll wait probably 48 hours on that one, and then we should be good to cast the first resin. So let's see how that go. I usually like the back of a spoon, it's nice and strong. You can lift everything up. Thank you. To open, so this is a good sign. At least we put enough Vaseline for the silicone not to stick to each other. So for this I just like to go nice and easy and just open it slowly all around. Take your time, don't force it. You want to see that the silicone is nice and dry inside before you completely open, so you can have a little peek in there. And to me it looks okay. Now this is the bottom part. I think we're good. There you go. Oh, nice and smooth. I think we're good. Silicone is a bit sticky here because I think I put a thinner layer of Vaseline. But we're looking good. There's the head. I'll pop it out. Now we got a little bubbles as well. That's a new type of silicone I used, so yeah, we'll have to see. Johnny, the good thing is this, when you get bubbles like that, so I don't know because I poured exactly the same, and you can see this one has no bubbles, it's perfect, and this one has bubbles trapped in. The only problem that I'm going to have, well, it's not really a problem, is that just I'm going to have a little bit more sanding because these bubbles will create a few pimples on the on the surface of the cast, so it's just going to give me a little bit extra work, like, but that's okay. Everything has come up quite okay. They're definitely usable molds. So same thing, I'm not going to touch them too much. I'm just going to close them back up, and I'm going to just let them dry like that. I close them very loosely, just not to get too much dust in there. Just leave them like that, hold up to the top, and let it dry for a couple of days, 2-3 days before we do the first resin pour. I'm excited now. Turns out really, really good. All right, guys. See you in 2 days.